Back at the crash site, a wing embedded in the roof of a car is one of dozens of pieces of wreckage Sidor needs to chart.
It's the right side. It's the right wingtip.
He wants to know if the plane came down in one piece or if it broke apart in mid-flight, something that would point strongly to a bomb.
Well, this is the nose. Yeah, the whole plane's here. There's no way it blew apart in the air.
So we had the left wing tip, both left and right, horizontal stabilizer and the vertical stabilizer. This told us that the whole aircraft had made it to the accident site, as we say.
The fact that the debris was so tightly clustered together on the ground really was strong evidence against the notion of an in-flight explosion.
Mexican and U.S. investigators breathe a collective sigh of relief. FBI test results confirm the finding.
Yeah, I gotta go. All right, bye.
There's no evidence of a bomb.
When the FBI took samples around various parts of the aircraft, and even, I believe, even on parked cars and in the building, they found no trace of any explosive device.
But the way the wreckage has fallen does provide a puzzling detail about how the plane came down.
It looks like the plane was heading west when they hit the ground. Flying away from the airport that way. So why are they flying the wrong way?
We knew that he was coming into Mexico City, and the first thing that we noticed was that the aircraft, when it struck the ground, was actually moving away from the airport.
The Learjet crashed into the heart of Mexico City at the height of rush hour. Investigators hoped to find somebody who saw something that might explain the odd flight path.
So you didn't see it in the air at all?
But they're out of luck. Witnesses can only describe the moment of impact and the terrifying aftermath.
Nobody knew what had happened and what it was that exploded, because there were several explosions, I think maybe two from the plane, and then of course all the cars. It was a very chaotic situation, a lot of panic in people's minds, like, what's going on?
No one can tell investigators anything about how the plane was flying before it suddenly changed direction and crashed.
How we say it with investigators is the accident didn't happen here. This was the result. The impact of the ground was the result of the accident, which occurred at altitude. And because of that, we didn't really have any witnesses to that part of the flight.
It's a disappointing setback for investigators, one that only increases the pressure to explain the mysterious crash in the Mexican capital.